not good at playing along. I'm my own person. I cast magic missile at the darkness.
Okay, the amount of times Raul said that yesterday was unbelievable.
Where's the Mountain Dew?
Are there any girls there?
Okay. So we're on the boat.
Can you?
I don't see a boat.
Patrick and Uncle Mike aren't here yet.
Well,
I'm here.
Well, hold on. okay, so you guys are on the boat and you're going to land to this big city.
Right. There's a giant. There's a giant flaming wreckage. Right.
Yeah. So like this city's huge. Like for the people who play World of Warcraft, it's like Stormwind huge. There were like 8 boat docks. The ship had hit the docks. Blew up about 4 of the dock spots.
Is it so big you would spell it UGE? It's huge.
UGE. It's huge. Okay. So so your boat goes to shore. And you kind of walk towards the city like nothing had happened. And Justin sees somebody following them. So,
oh,
go ahead.
Okay. I turn to Calf, my best friend, and I say, I think somebody's following us.
He's a punk ass bitch.
Which one is Calf on my screen?
Also, his name is Calf.
The archer. So just to recap,
and who
Uncle Mike.
Plays him?
No one. So here's what happened, Uncle Mike. Yesterday, what happened was we woke up in a boat, in a jail cell on a boat, and then we proceeded to kill everyone on the boat and escape, without asking any questions. And
I asked some questions.
Seems legit.
Right. When we got to the top of the boat, Raul cast a spell that alerted the captain and the first mate that we were killing everyone. And the captain came out to fight us, and our buddy Calf over here was actually one of the pirates on the boat, and he was so bad at archery, he shot the captain 4 times in the back. So, I said, in the middle of the fight, hey, do you want to just be on our team? And it worked. So, now he's with us. And Raul wants to kill him.
He ran around and stole all the gold.
No, what happened was... What happened was... Raul says, I'm gonna loot him. And then I say, you know what I think? I think our buddy Calf here, who did most of the work, should be able to loot him. And so then Calf proceeded to loot the captain and took like 1 gold piece or something, and now Raul's butthurt about it.
He shot at me. He tried
and so
to
here we
me.
Are.
He didn't shoot you, though. That's the point.
Oh, so when someone shoots at you and they miss, you're like, oh, it's okay. You didn't try to kill me.
It's fine.
I totally understand. My bad.
It's totally okay.
How do you not hate Trey? He tried to set you on fire.
Right. We're okay
yeah,
with
Trey's
that.
Mentally handicapped. We just have to agree whatever he's doing.
So,
how do you not hate Justin making a man bleed from his balls?
So with Justin, Calf kind of looks at you and recognizes, you know, somebody else is with you. And uh-huh. following you. I mean, he's within like 3 feet of you. He's like standing.
Oh, he's like
right
creeper stalking
you.
Us.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay. I look around to the rest of our group and I say, "What do we do?" Anybody? Anybody got any ideas? Okay.
Raul,
okay. Cool. Who are you?
Walk up to him and say.
Well, thanks for the suggestions,
okay,
everybody else.
Door,
who are you?
So, Patrick?
Oh, I've been with you guys the entire time. remember the time where you kicked that dude in the nuts so hard he bled everywhere? That was fun.
I remember you.
So how we're introducing him, how we're going to introduce him is you guys, you and Trey and Raul start getting flashbacks
uh-huh.
of like... him being on the boat with you guys.
So, Justin, so the episode of Community where Jack Black was in all of the episodes.
Oh, okay.
Like that. Just like that.
Okay. He's like behind boxes and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, I was.
Yeah. He was with us the whole time.
Now that I think about it.
Yep.
Now that I think about it, I remember Calf tried to shoot him, and and not Raul, and he ended up shooting the captain.
That's not how it works.
That's why those archers were so bad. They weren't shooting at any of us. They were shooting at him.
No. Oh. So they tried to kill our friend. That's it. He must go.
Hey, guys, what's I'm also name? New to the group. My name is Cal. Just kidding.
You'll be is Uncle Mike there with Patrick?
I don't know. Yeah, we'll just say.
And then somebody comes from the other direction and says, "Also, I was there too." And then we have another series of flashbacks.
No. So Patrick's explaining how he was there the whole time, and I jump out from the side like Step Brothers style and go, "Hello, Miss Lady.
Who are you?
Who are you? Think I can help with the whole Pam Pam dilemma?"
Oh, okay. Mike, it should also be noted how we ended our slaughter of the entire pirate ship. We killed everybody, including the people driving the boat, and Dre looked over the edge and realized we were heading ship full speed toward the dock, and so we left two survivors on the boat, cut all the life rafts, and then jumped in the last one, and then Trey set it on fire, and then it slammed into the docks of the city. And exploded.
So can I ask a question of my friends? Why are we standing out in the middle of the snow?
Well, for some reason, whoever's in charge of the thing isn't creative enough to give us a map of the city.
Because I wasn't prepared for winter. Like, I don't even have socks.
You're gonna hear
that. Who's that?
Carter.
Okay, so I instantly like all of you. That is the smallest city on the planet.
Yes, I'm
the size of Stormwind.
I'm king of the map. Yeah,
the map by
is that rude? That's RuneScape, thank God.
Oh.
We're getting there. We're getting there.
One more level.
Can we go deeper?
I thought it was RuneScape.
Where's my character?
This is getting really JPEG-y.
It will get extremely JPEG-y.
Where are we? Like, supposed to be? I assume down here.
Why'd you guys leave me in the canal?
Whoa.
Oh, there it is.
Mega JPEG.
God, I can't do this fucking mission.
Hey, we're playing a game.
Is this where are we at? Are we where everybody's at, or are we where I'm at? Or
yeah, where are we? Okay, where are we supposed to be, Steven? Four.
So we're going to. You guys have entered the city. So we're gonna say the docks are up here, like where I'm placing everybody. We only have five people. Where's Calf?
He's under the middle guy.
There he is.
he swallowed him again.
It's like
I'm not moving me.
It's like the second boss when he turns into a pot and keeps changing his location. What's that dungeon?
All right. So, am I to understand that the city is probably in panic mode?
Yeah, we're gonna do it like.
Is the city in panic mode?
The city is. But the docks are definitely in panic mode. The docks, everybody's going crazy around the docks.
Right. Should we assist with the flames?
That's up to you guys.
Trey,
do we want to assist with the flames?
We're just going to leave him alone.
Okay, we're going to leave him alone.
I don't want to deal with that.
I don't want to deal with that.
I turn to to no one, and I walk this way. What are these? I can't read the JPEG.
Okay, so in this first little area right here, you can't really read it. So we've got
Do we have an objective? Like, or are we just kind of dicking around?
You're going to go look for a quest. That's what the objective is.
Right.
Probably after a couple feet and you walk around a little bit, you'll find something. But you have down at the bottom here of this four block where you are right now. So you have the mayor's house right there.
Okay.
You'll have the mayor's house. You have the stables to your right, your left over here.
Yeah.
On the right side of your characters.
Ping.
I can't ping. Why can't I ping? I don't know how to ping.
Okay.
This is not helpful.
I would like to ask our fellow compatriots that just joined what their special skills are. Do we know? Do I know what you guys do?
I have skills up the butt.
Uh-huh.
I have expertise in persuasion and sleight of hand. That helps.
Okay.
Also have deception, athletics, performance, and stealth. Mm-hmm. I cannot be put to sleep by magic spells. And
spilling it out.
Patrick has four proficiencies in skills.
Six.
Whoa.
And two expertise.
That's interesting. Dude, are we all supposed to have that much, or is it just him?
No, rogues have four.
Okay.
Out of the four, the two of them are expertise. His half elf ability also gives him another two.
Okay, Mr. Monk Boy, who strode out from the bushes. Yeah.
From the white brick wall.
Yeah, I'm referring to you, who I just now learned your name. So.
My skills. I am the wind through the grass.
You can't do that while I'm taking a drink.
I'm strength at the base of the pillar.
Okay.
What kind of material is this pillar?
You're concrete.
Nice. What do you do? What do you bring to the table for this group?
I'm not bringing anything to the group. I'm seeking transcendence.
Okay. I strategically place myself in between Calf and Raoul the Magnificent.
Strategically. Hey, Will.
Hey.
Hey, we're playing.
There you are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, welcome, I suppose, to the group. I'm going to, I guess, walk down the street and just knock on the mayor's door. I mean, does anybody else have any better ideas?
Is there anybody on the street? Like, are we in a bad part of town? Or
I'm trying to find... Hold on. I'm trying to find these at least decent
tokens.
People icons. Yeah, people tokens. Actually, I'm just going to do this. This is a better idea right here.
Place little circles.
Are we... Is this a highly populated... Or is it crowded streets? What are we doing?
Hey, Will, do you want to be Calf?
Oh, I'm good. I'm about to get run.
Okay.
So you don't want to...
It's funny. I'm running right now in D&D.
Nuts.
Where are you running to, bro?
Your mom's house.
Perfect. Oof. Perfect.
The fuck?
Hey, why didn't that copy and paste?
Is it underneath the tile that you set?
It might be, you know. Now that I think about it, nope, it shouldn't.
I see a 40-foot.
Right, I'm gonna get my next one now.
Patrick's doing range.
Nice.
Oh, sorry.
Oh man, why can't I get?
Mine's longer than yours. Oh, I hit a help button. How?
There it goes. It adds people now.
Okay, cool.
Hey, look at that. Look at that thing.
What is that? Is that a snake? Oh, it's somebody sitting down.
Yeah. There we go. Boom. Cool.
Just gonna add some peeps. Oh, is that a mayor?
That's...
Alright, populate this place.
Are these wenches over here?
Is this like a hobo?
Yeah, he's a hobo. She's a hobo.
Oh,
yes. I give her all my money.
Wait, can I?
I literally give her all my money.
Can I?
Okay. You have 150 gold, I think.
I try and I want to pickpocket this hobo.
Oh, come on.
You pickpocket someone who has nothing?
I give her all 15 of my gold pieces.
Did you hear that? Now it has 15 gold.
I scream, hands to yourself, sneak thief!
Did you hear me? Do I subtract that from my character sheet?
Yeah.
Yes.
Steven, can you give me permission to move Kelf?
Let's just wait until Steven's done whatever he's doing.
Yeah, I'm waiting.
Just wait.
You can now move Kelf. Okay, so there's city guards, people walking around, all that kind of junk.
I recommend that she goes and gets a good night's sleep. And don't buy booze or I'll kill her.
Okay, so she's gonna...
I give Kurikai an approving nod.
You give Kurikai what?
An approving nod.
An approving nod. So she goes, and there's a guard there. So she walks... And she kind of leaves out of sight.
She kind of flew.
Yeah. Hey, Trey, are you going to join us?
She kind of ran to go get a...
nope.
To a bar. Not a bar. a tavern.
What? Is it like... Does it have rooms?
It's got rooms in it. But into the tavern.
Like an inn.
I have faith.
Find the tavern.
Maybe she's going to go buy sex.
Okay.
You didn't say no sex, so she's not gonna die.
So, all right. So I'm gonna walk down the street over here, and I'm going to knock on the mayor's door.
Where the hell is the door?
I'm just gonna assume one of these is the door.
Right there. That's the door.
Excellent.
So he's right here. So he answers the door. And of course, is where you need to be. Of course. So he says, he asks you, "What's going on? What's going on?"
So I say, "Looks like you had a bit of a pirate trouble down the docks."
Pirate trouble.
Uh huh.
What are you talking about, pirate trouble?
Well, your docks exploded.
He doesn't.
Oh.
He's referring to us burning our own ship and crashing it into the dock.
I don't think we were on that ship.
He nudges.
I nod disapprovingly. It seems like you guys have a couple of things you need to work out. We're willing to assist if you have anything that you need done. Comprende?
Comprende.
Is Spanish a language?
I don't know. Patrick's character speaks American. He kind of looks around, sees the big fire at the docks.
Right. Mm-hmm.
He's kind of okay with it.
He's kind of a bad man. We'll build more.
He says, "We'll get on that, and we'll have more people build the docks back up." You see a bunch of guards around his house, kind of protecting him. Also,
I see that.
He doesn't like new people, so he wants you to kind of get out. He doesn't like you telling him that. He needs help the burning boat.
Oh, right.
I figured.
How about...
You seem troubled, friend. Let's meditate.
That was the thing. Are we going to respond to that? He said, you seem troubled, friend. Let's meditate.
He seems kind of irritated that...
You would even suggest that.
You would even suggest that. He doesn't like that.
Sorry for wasting your time. Could you direct us to the nearest place for us to have a rest?
Yeah, he says if you keep wandering the streets down south.
Could he give us a number reference?
a quadrant, if you would.
Plot 9.
Okay. Uh-huh.
down south, and there should be a place you can stay in a local bar and tavern.
Where can we buy weapons?
Buy things. Buy weapons. That'll be plot 6.
Oh, thank you for your specificity. enjoy.
Have a GPS.
Enjoy your self-wallowing.
Can we check out this guy? See if he's got anything for us.
The guard.
This guy over here.
That's a guard, I think.
Is he that's a loyal guy. Which one?
This guy that I'm next to, right here.
Who the hell are you?
Yeah, this guy.
He's a normal guy.
He's
just walking in the town.
Yeah.
Hey, normal guy.
Wait. Oh, Uncle Mike is the blue one.
Yeah.
The kick-ass looking monk.
What are you talking about? I'm a wizard.
So.
I got like a ponytail and everything, dude.
Calf and I are gonna lock arms at the elbow, and we're gonna walk down the street towards 8 and 9. I mean, we're gonna go this way.
Wait. What does this guy say?
He was just a normal guard. We decided to ignore him.
He was like, hey.
What's going on?
What's going on?
Hey, we're moving together.
Ooh, a smithy. Can I talk to the smithy?
Dude, you just jumped on top of him.
What? You put yours...
Is that on? Is it on?
Yeah, this the guy you're talking to.
Roll for initiative.
If you want to talk to him, he's an armorer.
Hello, sir.
This is hello. Would you like to buy anything?
Yeah.
I sell. I have a bunch of steel goods. Breastplates, swords. He's a blacksmith.
Carbon fiber?
I would like to ask him if he can make me one with everything.
One with everything?
Uncle Mike, you have no money.
He asks you if you would like the front to fall off.
Sick reference.
So, Calf and I
make anything out of steel.
Calf and I take a seat at the bar.
I would like to ask him if he could inspect my sword.
The one that I'm at.
Where's that?
I'm not sure. I was told to go to quadrant 9.
Where's quadrant?
Look at barkeep.
Quadrant. I like how we're saying quadrant.
Yeah, 12th tint.
So, So I'm talking to his armor, and I say, can you inspect my sword, please? And tell me if he has a higher quality sword.
Higher quality sword? That's a piece of crap sword, he says. Mine are the best in all of the lands.
Azeroth.
In all of Azeroth. I don't even know what that is.
Do I even have any gold?
I do. Would you like some? I come from a wealthy family. I'm not near you. I can't talk to you.
Is this a coin thing?
Hey, I met your twin sister. I gave her $15.
No, that is her.
That is the girl. That is her.
That is the same girl.
Inventory. Oh, it's you. No wonder you look the same.
No wonder you look the same.
GP.
Would you like to have a seat next to Calf and I? Kafir is going to tell us why he was a pirate on a pirate ship. Maybe he has a cool backstory.
He has absolutely no backstory. He was just a pirate. He wasn't even supposed to be part of your journey.
Oh, man.
Well.
That's strike one, two, and three.
Well, I'm about to make up a backstory for Kel. Does he really have no backstory?
No, I made one up.
Okay. Okay, let me hear it. When Raul is done buying armor or whatever, I'd like to hear Kalf's life story.
So what's the stats on his weapon, on his sword?
It's the best sword you could ever have. There's no real stats on the sword, Raul. You can't inspect it and look at it and have more stats. You can't know that it has more stats.
Okay. I would like to sell him this sword for one of his swords. And ask him how much
you want to barter.
He sells his sword for one gold apiece, but if you trade him the sword, it'll cost you 75 silver.
Alright, I'll take it.
You'll take it. So he exchanges the sword with you and takes your old sword and kind of throws it over into a pile of all these swords and armor and the steel scrap pile almost.
Yeah.
And then he hands you one of his well-made swords, one of his better swords that he's ever made, and hands it to you.
Okay. This is exciting. So what do I type in here? Well-made steel sword?
Egan, type in steel sword. it does the same damage, Raul. It's a sword.
God damn it! Why I'm just gonna give him the whole gold because I don't feel like converting that.
So. Use a tip.
What? Oh, whatever. Alright. Punk ass bitch sold me stupid sword.
He literally gave you nothing. Calf, what's...
Well-made steel sword.
Well, Calf's backstory is...
Tell me about yourself. I want you to tell it like you're Calf.
Okay. I was born in a small town, and the pirates had come and ransacked the town, and I was only 7 years old, so I had joined them, and they paid me, and I just had nowhere to live. They killed my family, and I was
forced to live
my life as a pirate. Uh-huh. And to
yourself.
Well, Calf, I'm glad we can save you from that pirate life, and you just know that you're among friends.
Nope.
To Calf. Nope. As we raise our glasses.
To Calf.
Cling.
I pour my drink out. I hate you, Calf.
Can we short rest so I can get my stuff back and they can get their spell? Or I get my dragon breath back. Do they get their spells back from a short rest, or do they have to long rest for a spell?
They'll get their spells back.
Being loosey goosey with the rules there. I like it.
I mean, you guys were on the boat.
Sure.
So, if you guys go to bed, Raul, are you going to short rest?
I'm gonna hang out here with Cal for a bit.
Raul, you when you take your short rest, you see the rod that you have.
Yeah.
It kind of glows.
Is that in quotes, the rod?
Oh, wait. That was also a bit as we're resting, I'm filling in our two new people on what we did yesterday. Today, I suppose, like an hour ago. And I let them know that there was a rod on some dude's dead body that I passed up that Raul picked up that turns him into a giant fire beetle.
Excellent.
Yes.
And as you're resting, it also gains, and you can sense that it gained its power back. It had power still left on it, but it gained full power again, so it's again at full power.
Yes! I say, oh sweet, and then I fall asleep.
Do we remember anything about the day before? Like, does anything come back to us? Like, we kind of woke up and the last thing we remembered was being at a bar together. Is it assumed that we are friends?
It's assumed that you were in the bar. You weren't necessarily all friends.
Oh.
You
were
just in the bar, kind of drinking, and then a big bar fight, you know, broke out.
Yeah.
So, you guys really weren't friends, but you had met each other. But not enough to, like, really know each other.
Acquaintances.
Your acquaintances, there you go.
Excellent. So, yeah. Or anything else happened during our rest?
So the bartender comes and runs to you, and he tells you that he's got the classic adventure problem. He's got too many rats in his down in the bar cellar.
Ah, shit to kill. That's what shit I like to
remind
kill.
Him that's a health violation.
I ask him what grade he got at his last health inspection.
He says health inspection. What's that?
Oh. Why? Well, I look to Calf and I say, "You wanna kill some rats?"
Calf kind of looks at you and kind of nods his head that he's gonna go ahead and want to kill some rats with you.
Excellent.
I ask if he needs help because I know he won't be able to hit a target.
Nice.
I say to him.
Then I
turn to Trey and ask him if he's gonna need help because he won't be able to hit the targets either.
Ooh,
I remind him I lit a boat on fire.
And I remind him it's not that hard to light a boat on fire.
Let me see you do it, bitch.
Kirk has started to say something.
I inform the bartender that sometimes you're the rat, sometimes you're the cheese.
Are you going to be speaking in, like, Confucius?
And then I sit in the corner and meditate.
Excellent. You're my favorite so far.
And say, why do you have a staff? I want it.
I continue to meditate as if he doesn't exist.
Nice. I turn to Kirk and I say, I already got the hang of it.
Are we going to kill rats?
I'm ready to kill rats. I asked the bartender, what do we get out of this? What's my incentive?
Who the hell are the rats?
And he remains silent.
Hold on, I'm counting. He says, hold on, I'm counting. he's counting his gold.
Oh.
But anyway,
He said he'll give you some gold out of it, and that what the fuck? Yeah, that's exactly what he says.
All right, show me to the rats.
How do I send direct messages, Steven?
Slash W space name. Duh. That distorted it to all hell.
Are we gonna kill rats? Can we kill rats?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Okay.
I'm working on it.
Okay, did you get my message, by the way? Did that work?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, I just realized in my inventory I have the material components to Morning Cadence.
To what? Okay, you're talking really quietly.
He was recording a video.
No, I look in my inventory. I literally have the material components to Morning Cadence Magical Servant.
Why do you have that?
I forgot I did that when we...
Oh, you put them in there yourself.
And my quarterstaff has a description of this shit cracks some heads, yo.
Nice.
I don't know if this is too big or too small. What the heck?
I have that problem.
Most people
the time.
Say that about my quarterstaff.
Well, you know, it's a quarter of whatever it is.
Go on.
Perfect. Got it. Cool. So you're going to go kill some rats. Oops. That's my bad.
Are we talking supernatural rats, or are we talking like me stomping on some heads?
Rad rats.
Nice.
This map is racist.
Why, because it's black?
Get over it. Sent you a message, Steve.
Oops.
Alright, is that the entrance over there on the left?
Yes, that is.
Okay.
Oh, hello.
Hello. I guess we're the first two down.
Yeah. I think Kurikai is still up there meditating.
Ah.
It's all black. I can't see anything.
We're all the way on the left if you zoom out. Or you can right click and drag to the left.
Can I zoom out?
There's a little
top right
thing. Or you can hit control and mouse wheel.
I got you.
Bing.
So on mouse wheel just moves up.
Oh, I can't move him anymore. Cal,
I have to reset it so you can control him.
That's alright, we're in a dungeon thing.
Where's my character?
You have to click your bio and info on the character. Yeah. Yeah. And then just click your picture and then click it on the map. Click and drag.
I mean, I see it. And then
is it
I
huge?
Click on the map and it disappears.
Well, if it's in the black, it'll disappear.
No, I put it on the what?
Steven, can you see where his is? There it
is.
Is.
I see 50 of him.
Well, I kept dragging.
Patrick, you should, or whatever your name is. What's your name? Spicy Boy? Spicy you should boy. Let me go first.
There you go. You can see that now, instead of being black.
By all means. That's Dragon Bjorn?
Yes, Dragon Bjorn.
Okay, Dragon Bjorn, lead the way.
I say Cav should go first, so he doesn't shoot any of us.
I'm okay with standing in between.
I trust him to walk. Behind me.
Back armor?
I trust him to walk behind me.
I've been here the whole time, so I trust him.
Steven, do you have a response to what I said?
To what?
To what I said to you.
Don't
say it out loud.
I did.
Okay. Do you agree? Okay. So, I'm just gonna start walking.
Yeah. Stop.
Ooh. Guys, should we go right or keep going?
Ooh. We have enough to split into
right
two teams.
Here.
I'll take Calf and myself, and we can head up this way. If anybody wants to go down this way.
Do we want to have one? I mean, we can split 3 and 3 if we would like. We can go 3 in one way and 3 the other.
We could.
Really? I will follow Raul. What is
his name is Raul.
What's your name?
His name is Raul.
Oh.
Oops.
Oh, don't do that. Nobody look.
Close your eyes.
Your
eyes.
Okay.
That was nothing, though, so it's okay.
Okay.
Trey, what's your guy's name?
Moisture missile.
Moisture missile. Are you coming with us, or are you following? Oh.
Steven, give me
like
Calf.
Kurikai is following.
I haven't decided yet.
You should probably yell back down the hallway to that you should follow Spicy Boy and Raul.
Bing.
I still roll him.
Yeah.
But Justin,
I'm going to move him for you.
You can now, you have full control over him now. Like, you can get his portrait and everything.
Okay. Alright, so I'm going to move up this way. With the Calf in tow.
Are you going to lead, or would you like I, or?
I mean, I don't mind leaving, but I don't. Is this open? Or is this just a dead end?
Oh, you. Well, I just saw you walk over there, so hold on.
Oh, wow. All right.
Steven, what is this at the end of the hallway over here?
Whoa,
it's a door.
It's a door? Okay.
Mouse!
Take it down.
Take it down.
Alright. Since I'm melee, I will go first.
Alright.
At some point, I'm gonna use my sweet-ass new sword.
Your stronger one?
Mage.
He's
clearly at the weakest.
Nice. Can I attack him? May.
Yes. Go ahead and roll initiative.
All of us or just the three of them?
Just the three of them.
Okay. Put your token up so it works.
Where's that again in core stat?
Oh, 25.
Oh, it's in core stat?
Yeah there's an initiative button. Yeah.
Core stat.
I'm trying to find it.
It's right next to your core stats.
And then it's right under hit points.
Ah.
So we're standing in front of a door?
Right. I'm about to try and open it. when...
Wait, I put my hand on yours.
My initiative thing is not working.
You put my hand...
you open it.
Uh-huh.
Like, I block you from the handle on it, so I just wait.
Okay.
Man.
I trust...
a piece of advice before we walk through this door.
I trust your wisdom.
Man with hand in bush, not necessarily trimming the shrubs.
I stand in stunned silence for several seconds.
I must meditate on this.
Before I turn...
I sit down.
Back around. And I try the handle.
Wait, do you jiggle it? Or just touch it?
Your initiative isn't working, Trey?
Nope.
What does it say when you click it?
There it goes.
Token thing.
You have to click on your person. Click on your...
It is a mouse.
No, that... Steven rolled the mouse.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I can roll the mouse.
Oh. So, Trey, click on your little midget guy on the map and then hit initiative. Yeah. There you go. The mouse rolled 3, or the spicy boy rolled 3.
No, that was Steven.
Yeah.
Steven rolled again, because I didn't.
I rolled. It says spicy boy, but if I target something and then use anybody's initiative button, it'll say whoever initiative button I used.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Because I don't have an initiative button for some
reason. Gotcha.
So is that me? Am I good to...
You're good to attack
this mouse up.
Yeah. Can you wait before they start fighting? Can you tell me if the door was unlocked?
Go with the door.
The door is unlocked. You kind of jiggle the handle.
Okay. Yeah. I open the door and then I'll wait for them to do a round.
Okay.
So am I good? You good?
Yeah, you're good to go.
So can I go with a little sneak attack action here?
I think he knows.
Yeah.
I don't know if he knows. Well, no. Because, let's see.
Yours says...
Once per turn, I can deal an extra 1d6 damage to one creature you hit with an attack. If you have advantage on the attack.
Well, you have to have advantage. Oh, he does.
You do not... You're right. You do not have advantage. So, no, you can't have the sneak attack.
Alright, well, then let's just go with...
You're gonna stab. You're gonna stabby stab.
Let's just stab.
Click roll on your knife. Roll on your sword, or whatever you want to use. You hit him, and he is dead.
Wow! What a fight.
He is. He's a gone rat.
I figured this is what was gonna happen. I'm gonna go in this door.
You go in, and before you go into the door.
Uh huh.
You kind of peek into the room.
Okay, excellent. I turn around to Kurikai and I say, "Hope you're ready to kick some ass, because there's a rat with a sword."
There's a rat with a sword.
Hang on, he's looking up.
To say about this one.
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm ready for some pre-battle meta.
Just remember. Remember.
Uh huh.
He used to cut an open window, get painted neck.
We can't hear
you.
This.
Continue to baffle me. I'm ready to run full speed into this room.
Full speed into the room. Okay.
So I'm gonna. I'm just gonna run. I'm gonna run right here.
Full and advantage. Okay.
And I'm gonna.
I have like all the move speed.
Okay.
Go ahead and roll initiative, but you're going to attack first, whatever order you're in.
Okay. Nice.
You're probably going to be last anyway. Thank you for rolling, Calf. I hate how it doesn't allow me to roll initiative on these guys.
Do you want me to roll for you?
I got it. I just have to have somebody's character sheet open.
(Clears So I'm going to get a first hit, right?
So you're going to get a first hit. Oh, closed it. That's awesome.
You're the best.
Perfect.
There it is. It wasn't cleared yet, so it's fine.
You're going to go ahead and get a first hit, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to hit that one. And I'm going to go with my trident. And it's going to do that.
You hit it.
Nice.
It takes a pretty big
roll.
Hit.
Where's his roll at?
On the right. Hit the chat bubble.
The chat.
There it is. So I hit it. I stab it. Yeah.
All right. Yep. You stab it. It takes damage. That one's dead. That one you just.
Oh, nice.
The 10 damage was enough for a small rat.
Yeah. I was about to say, if that didn't kill that wimpy rat, Patrick did, 9 damage or something? 8?
8.
Yeah, that rat be dead, yo. Give it an X.
Give it an X.
And take it off the initiative. He's the 14 one.
Is he the 14?
Yeah. Yeah. If you mouse over it, yeah. If you mouse over it. I kill the rat and I say, get him, Calf.
So Kurikai is next.
No, it's okay. I didn't see that. I didn't see him ahead.
I get my quarterstaff and an unarmed strike, right?
Yes.
How do I ping the map?
Just click and hold.
That's how I'm attacking.
Okay.
How come I didn't do anything?
What do you do? Okay, so go to your weapons, and then all the way on the right, there's attack.
That's what I click.
Do you have all of your stuff set? Like, do you have an attack stat, damage dice? There it is. Holy crap.
You got a 25 on the hit.
Yeah.
So you're gonna do a bit of bludgeoning. And then hit him.
And he gets an unarmed too, yeah?
Unarmed strike. Do you have the unarmed strike also?
Nice, another 7.
Oh,
man.
Yeah, he annihilated that rat. The rat's head is caved in. And
nice.
He kind of smashed it.
As my fist caves in his skull, I shout, "The gods strike through me!"
That's the number 3. The 3 rat.
Yeah, I got him. Okay, so Cal's gonna take aim, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, Cal, please.
Get him, boy! Get him, boy!
Right in the back.
Who's he hitting? Who's he going for?
Justin, did you take your shield off?
He's going for the other rat. He's going for the other rat.
Yeah.
Justin, please tell me your shield is on your back.
No. I have faith.
So he's gonna hit the rat. He doesn't get any bonuses. He's got base hit right there. So he hits the rat for 3.
Uh-huh.
Rat's still alive, but the rat took an arrow. And
you did. Yeah, the rat takes the arrow, and I turn and I go, "You did it!"
So you giving him the grace that he finally, you know, hit his target. He gets an addition to his attack roll next turn.
Yeah.
Nice.
Inspiring.
Inspiring.
Little courage bonus there. Way to go.
Calf is really growing.
Come on.
Okay, so this rat's gonna come and he's gonna kind of push this dead rat out of the way here.
Mm-hmm.
He's gonna come at you, Justin, and he's gonna swing
balls.
18.
Out. He's gonna go 11, and he's not gonna hit.
Of course not.
So he kind of glances across your shield.
Uh-huh.
So this little rat, he's gonna kind of corner you and come around.
Yeah.
And this rat's really gotta hit you.
And he doesn't.
I'm waiting for it.
He doesn't. Nice. He's like a kind of he bites.
Nice.
It bites your chainmail and it kind of breaks his tooth. So you don't take any damage.
He bites my chainmail. That's it. That's it.
So it's your go.
Oh, my turn. Okay.
And at this time,
yeah.
If Spicy and Raul and
if you guys want to make a move there,
if you want to kind of move around in that area,
yeah, I'll let you.
There's this rat here.
The rat's dead. He's smished.
Smished.
Yes, it's a new word. Look it up.
So Trey went into the hallway down there.
There's a door there.
Trey. Okay.
Oh. What about this hallway? Is this revealed?
Again, there's a door right here. And there's nothing down that hallway. There's a wall right there on that doorway.
Okay. Yeah, that's a wall, Patrick.
I know. What? Oh.
Okay. Is that what you guys are going to do?
I jiggle the handle. On nice. The door.
The door's what? Locked. The door's locked. Oh.
It's still
running. God damn
it. It's still
It's a big steel door.
Check on the handle.
It's kinda bolted all down the side, so it's
oh yep, it's there locked. He's going for that one.
All right,
that one is also locked.
Hmm.
You can't seem to get in that way.
Trey, do you want to try and fireball the door off?
I can light the
aren't you a rogueway?
I don't have the abilities to.
Is Trey the pyromaniac weakness or something?
No, Trey set everything on fire on the boat.
I know, he just said he could set stuff on fire.
Yeah. He's just got a summon fire spell or whatever.
Can I lockpick the door? I attempt to pick the lock.
Roll me a 1d20. Or roll me a 1d20. No bonus. Good. No, you failed the lockpick.
Oof.
17.
Where'd it go?
Must be very hard.
Like my dick.
Fall out.
Nice.
Perfect.
All right, can we go back to fighting?
Yeah.
Yep. That's your
I trust in the skills and abilities of my good friend Kalf to take out the small rat, so I'm going to turn my attention to the rat, the sword-wielding rat, and I'm going to raise my spear high aloft my head, and I'm going to jab it straight at his neck. And, looks like I'm gonna kill him.
he takes a big chunk of damage from here.
Yeah.
He takes it in the neck.
Right.
He's bleeding. He's got your neck. His spear in his neck.
Yeah.
But he's still swinging.
So. Oh, well, lucky. Three rats dead, so it's up to Kurikai.
I'm sorry, which one's dead?
The three rat, the one on the left.
The one in front of you.
The one just directly in front of you, with the skull and crossbones. No.
The big one's not dead yet?
Big one's not dead yet. I stabbed it in the neck for what looks like 12 points of damage. Like, I kind of size it up, and I turn to you and I say, looks like he just took 12.
In the heat of battle, I tell Just, wait, what's your character?
Dragon.
Dragon.
Yeah.
Born.
Dragon
when this
Bjorn.
Is over, yep. We must meditate on the fact that this man's cellar is bigger than the city. And then I strike.
Oh my goodness. He does more damage than me. What is this crap?
He's a monk.
He's a monk.
Oh my gosh. Meditates.
Dude, seriously, meditation jacks up your
You head. Just did, you hit a 22, and then the damage is stupid.
Is he dead? Because I got an unarmed strike. I'm going to do like an elbow drop, WWE style.
So you smacked him across the face with your quarterstaff there, and he kind of tumbles down and falls.
And he's alive?
He appears to be dead.
Appears
well,
to
I'm
be.
I'm gonna elbow drop him WWE style.
He rolled another max roll.
This guy gets smashed.
He explodes all over the room in a bloody heap.
His chest caves in, and it's a huge amount of damage.
I'm gonna go put my laundry in the dryer.
Okay.
Squirrel who climbs up women's leg, not find nuts.
Only disappointment.
Get him, Calf. You sexy beast with your bonus attack roll this round.
So can we kill Raul while he's gone?
No.
So he shoots his bow. Calf shoots.
Does he and shoot me?
And Harrow drops in front of him.
Does he shoot me?
Justin, roll a d20. Uncle Mike, roll a d20.
I have acrobatics. Does that help?
Yeah, roll your d20 for acrobatics.
Just roll the skill.
Roll the skill.
Yeah, you can click acrobatics.
Justin, do you have
I can roll acrobatics. Yeah. I'll just roll acrobatics. Same.
Okay, so...
It goes through both of us?
It goes between both of you.
Uh-huh.
It barely misses. It barely misses you guys and hits the dead body of the already dead rat. The big big rat with the sword.
Yeah, and I turn to him and say, "Don't worry, buddy, you'll get him next time."
Congratulations on a fine kill.
I say, "Wow, look what you did to the big one."
So the small rat's going to attack you. You killed him. He's going to again glance your and nibble on your chainmail there.
Right, and then just to finish this battle off real quick before we go back to normal, I'm just going to murderize this rat real quick. Bye. No. Bye.
Yep. Okay,
Bye, rat.
25.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
all right,
they
cool.
all die.
They don't. They have nothing on their tiny rat body.
They have nothing on them. If you want to skin them,
okay,
you can skin them.
No, I'm okay with that. And after our battle is over, I turn to Kurikai and I say, I'm ready to meditate with you.
Excellent. Because man with hand in pocket feels cocky all day.
I saw your skills in battle, and I wish to learn your ways.
Excellent. Let's meditate.
Excellent. I will meditate. And so we meditate while we wait for somebody to return.
Everybody else.
From washing clothes.
So.
And I invite Calf to have a seat over by me, and I tell him, keep your head up, scamp. You did good back there.
So, I'm going to go round two on this door.
I'm going to go round two.
Because nothing can go wrong with that. How are you?
17 again. So you try again, and it doesn't much.
Okay, someone else try. Someone else do something, because I have tried twice.
This door is hacking.
I leave, because we obviously can't get the door open.
We've only tried one door.
Okay, I knock on this door. And see if anyone's inside.
Throw me a d20, Trent.
He knocked.
So you hear some loud noises coming from the other side and kind of feel the banging on the wall. You can feel that something's trying to come through the door, but it can't. It can't get the door open.
I while they're chilling over there, trying to figure out how they're going to get in their door, and it appears that Raoul has stood still in the hallway. I get up from my meditation, and I give another approving nod to our friendly monk, and I move up to this door and I try the door.
Roll me a d20 with just roll me a d20.
Do you want a perception one?
Give me it's actually going to...
Get out of here. You can't walk that fast.
It's going to be roll me a d20 on performance.
Get him.
Yeah, you gracefully open the door.
Excellent.
Yes.
I walk into the doorway.
That's not how this works. Not any of this works.
This works.
Oh my god.
Oh. So
Roll, get
turns.
Back here. Trey, get over here.
I'm What's going upstairs on? To ask the barkeep if he has a key.
Hmm. Oh, that's good smart. Deal.
Good idea.
Raoul, you're not over here, by the way.
Well, it is. I ran over there.
Well, you guys are...
Do you
split.
See the lightning coming from his hand? He's like the Flat.
Ew. So you just abandoned them over there.
And I am left by myself.
I turn around and I see Raoul following us, and I say, why? Why are you following us? Did you just leave the other two over there without anything? Any word?
You never leave your wingman.
I don't respond.
I move back.
We should have been notified that he was coming because I clearly told you I had the material components for a watchdog.
Okay, so the barkeep did have a key tray.
Oh, thank God.
That's somebody thought of it.
Well, I use it to open this door.
Let me type to you real quick.
What the heck is this? Is this a wall or a door?
Well, I actually moved back here because I'm concerned about our other half of the party now that Raoul's here with nobody else. I think something bad might have happened to them. And I'm going to check on them. I'm gonna make it down to this hallway and I'm gonna yell and see if they're there. Can they hear me from here?
Yes.
Yeah, is that allowed, Steven? Can I yell at them?
Yes.
Are you guys okay? Raoul just tagged along.
Send him back here so I can light him on fire.
And I see Raoul there. And I say hello.
I say hello there, young monk. Or old monk. It looks like we've been abandoned.
I'm glad we're together.
Come here, we might need some help.
Because it takes many nails to build a crib, but only one screw to fill it.
I'm going to walk back over here, and I'm going to yell to them down the hall, hey, they got the key to the door. Calf and I are going to go help them out. Do you think you can handle this way? Do you think you can handle this?
I jiggle the door.
You jiggle the door. Please roll me a 1d20 real quick.
I yell to Kurakai, since Raoul seems to be ignoring everybody. Will you be okay if Calf and I go and help out Moisture Missile and Spicy Boy? Can you give me a proverb? An affirming proverb, please. Or
he who stands on toilet is high on pot.
I put my fist in my palm and I bow, and then I run back over here.
I nod in approval.
Nice. All right, so Calf and I make our way around, and when I get here, I tell them that Calf did an amazing job fighting the last rats. He shot a big one.
Is this door unlocked? I laugh my ass off as I open the door.
Okay.
What's this see here?
Hold on, I gotta... Wait, is Raul open the door? Or tried to open the door?
Yeah, Raul. So
rolled a 15.
Uh-huh. Swear to God, if he gets that door open, I'm gonna punch a baby.
I'm sorry, roll a 1d10. 1d10, sorry.
I swear. Good. Better not open the fucking door.
Shotgun blast.
Three. So he goes and opens up the door and sets off a trap.
Nice.
Yes.
Wait, we don't know this though.
Please be
no.
Dead.
We don't know that.
We don't know this.
It's an arrow trap. So the arrow set off and hit it, and it's in the way of Uncle Mike too. So Uncle Mike's there. Can you guys roll a 1d20? For acrobatics.
Major acrobatics skill.
Roll for acrobatics.
Wouldn't it be a dex, sir?
Yeah. Boom! It is dex. Yeah. Acrobatics is dex.
Yeah, just roll your...
Just roll your acrobatics. There's an acrobatics. Just go to skills, and there's a dice next to acrobatics that you can click.
Hey, boom, 20.
So Raul doesn't get out of the way, and Raul gets hit, and he's gonna take 4 damage. From the trap. And the door won't open. The door's locked. There's no way to get past that door.
Does Raul like fall on the ground?
No, he's still alive, but he takes 2 arrows.
I'm assuming he kind of staggers backward.
Yeah,
a little bit.
Staggers backward.
What do you do, Uncle Mike?
I catch him as he staggers backwards.
Uh-huh.
I say. Even the greatest of whales is helpless in the desert.
Okay, so you guys open that door down there, and we open this door.
You guys aren't moving yet. You don't move yet, Raul.
You guys see a big cavern, so you guys found his rat problem.
Oh, we did.
Oh, this is the rat problem.
Oh, that's a green rat.
That's a lizard man.
Perhaps this arrow in your chest is a sign pointing to the direction we should be heading.
This way, young man.
So this guy is
sitting there, and Calf is wondering how these giant rats got through the doors, because the doors are simply too small for this giant rat.
Right.
Calf's the smart cookie.
Yeah. So I'm going to...
tank it.
I'm gonna run in first, right here.
Yeah, you tank that mess.
I'm gonna stand right here, and I'm gonna turn around to Moisture Missile and say, "Get your heels ready. You guys, quit moving.
What?
You can't
this is
move.
Taking time. We can move.
No, we're about to start initiative. You can't move.
Do you know what a monk's move speed is, dude?
It's fast, faster than Raul's.
Who just got shot in the chest with 2 arrows?
Right.
So here we go. All right, are we rolling initiative?
We roll initiative.
All right, you have to stop moving now.
A bird in one's hand makes it hard to blow nose.
You're right there.
Just wait till they're not looking.
I'm watching you the whole time.
I will show you how to be a grass at home.
Where's the thing?
Where's what?
Where's the square for?
Oh shit!
The what? I don't know what.
I'm watching you do this. Come on. Like I'm down for like having fun, like being goofy, but I kind of want to play this part at least the right way.
I think you just want.
Oh wait, did you get Calf? Justin, did you roll for Calf?
I'll roll Calf. Boom. Nice 7.
We are.
You two roll as well.
We already did.
No.
Raul and Uncle Mike.
Yeah.
Oh, there's no way we can make it over there. It's so far.
No, you like you guys roll so you can take a spot, and then you move during your turn so you can make it to us. Nice.
Oh, there you go.
There you go.
That's what we need. Do you have any?
Go fish.
All right, Uncle Mike.
That's you, dog.
How much? What's my move?
I think you. It's 30 for 30 for a single move. Unless it's core stats speed. No, top right. 25. Are you over encumbered? Do you have too much?
I have nothing.
Oh. So you can do double for 50. Which is 5 feet. So you can move 10.
A double move.
How do I do that? How do I make that arrow?
There's a comb. There's a comb.
There's
a
ruler.
It's a ruler.
It's a comb.
That's 40. 10, yeah, you can make it there. Bing. All right, Uncle Mike's done. Back rat is up. Oh, we rested too. I got all my health back, right?
Yes.
Okay, didn't do that. There we go.
Trey's up. Take a shot there. I hope we don't hit Justin.
How far away is Lizard Man?
Lizard?
Can you see him through the door?
No way.
He can.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see right there.
35. Take a step up.
Yeah, take a step up into the doorway.
So, I wonder how far this goes. So I'm 30 feet now?
Yeah.
32. I cast Animal Friendship on Lizard Man.
Oh!
Nice.
Animal Friendship on Lizard Man?
Better get it.
I'm going to write down a number. That's what you have to do.
Oh. You have to hit the number?
That number?
You have to
or above it.
That number.
Oh, okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Roll a d20.
Roll a d20.
Oh my
so
God.
Not only does
he
it not work,
he becomes charmed by the lizard.
Yeah, I was about to say it has a reverse effect.
Please God, please.
You are so
bad.
Does he just start yelling attack, and then he's
he gets mad, and now he has disadvantage on his next attack.
Sorry. Okay, let's see.
Off to a good start, guys.
Yeah. So,
They can't see you, Patrick?
I know.
If you were to sneak, roll me a stealth check.
How far can I go with that?
I see my skills out.
How do you see? What's your skill?
Your spellbook.
Spellbook.
You don't have any spells. Monks don't get spells.
See, how far do I go with that?
What do you mean, how far?
How far can I move with stealth?
30. You have 30 space.
Can he?
You can move full speed. You just have to be stealthy.
So you can
get a roll of stealth check.
You gotta get. You can get in, right?
Yeah, he can get in. He can share the doorway to move.
Yeah, I can get to here. But that's my whole turn, right?
No,
you have
your movement, and then you have your action step.
Okay, so I can do that.
You can just drag the arrow from you to there.
Yeah, that's actually how it is. You'll actually do this.
25.
And that's only 25 for you.
So you can go one more if you want it. You can get one more square, probably.
So you stealth past him. He doesn't know you're there at all.
You guys realize I'm 3'1".
You're 3'1"?
Yes.
hands.
Nice.
So wait. So wait.
Hey, your quarterstaff is longer than you are.
Do I have it?
What?
Do I have advantage?
Yes, you have advantage. He doesn't know you're there.
All right, let's go with my sneak attack. 1d6.
So you're gonna hit him first. You're gonna hit him with your sword.
Okay.
And then you add 1d6 to the attack the damage.
Okay. So roll your sword.
One attack.
Nice.
So 7, and then roll a piercing. I mean, roll a 1d6.
I mean, I can just roll a 7.
Oh, you're right. You're right. No, sorry. You hit a 12. You hit a 12. But he has advantage. When you
have to roll
hit that button. It says.
Roll another.
Roll for advantage.
Yeah, roll another 20 with your attack modifier.
Wait.
So roll a 20 and add your 2 hit.
So roll a d20.
Just roll any d20. Plus his whatever.
Yeah, plus 5.
So he hits, right?
He hits.
Yeah.
And then, he had advantage, so he didn't take his advantage.
Right.
You're supposed to roll with advantage, attack with advantage.
I'm going to give you that drop down, Patrick.
Yeah, when it gives you that with that input value, just so you see it, click on the attack again, like the attack dice, and it should say normal when it's there, it down and do with advantage.
Yeah.
See, there you go. So you'll hit there. And you do 6 piercing. So roll me another 1d6 for your sneak attack.
Oh, got him!
Nice. 12 pops him. Of course, this lizard, this rat guy, is still alive.
Okay, so we're up to Raulito.
All
right.
You can move another 25 because, what's your move?
I don't know. I don't have it.
Good.
I don't have my speed.
What are you? You're a human?
Yeah.
Your speed is 30.
Okay.
So you can move 60.
What?
Yeah. So instead of taking your action step of attacking, you can use your action to take another sprint.
Oh, Uncle Mike is a small person.
Yes. That's why he's run slower.
No, I just don't cover as much ground.
My turn. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna jump stab this rat into the chest.
Nice. Into the chest.
Yeah.
Are you going full on Brad Pitt and Troy?
Yeah, I'm doing exactly that move, but with a trident instead.
Okay, roll your attack. You did not hit.
Oh man.
He did not take 10 damage out of his armor class. His armor class is high enough for that.
Uh-oh.
And he's going to just kind of scrape it off and look meaner at you.
Oh, man, that's okay.
With a 17?
Yeah.
With a 17.
Oh, boy. It doesn't happen, and I turn around to Moisture Missile, and I say, hey, you better get that healing word ready.
Okay, so Cal's going to go this time.
Uh-huh. Where's my boy going? Can I shout in some instructions to Calf?
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, Calf, see if you can take that key to the other door.
All right, so he goes to Trey, because Trey's got the key right now.
Moisture Missile.
Does Moisture Missile give him the key?
Yes.
Okay, so he's going to take the key, and he's going to go all the way to the other door. He's going to make it to the other door.
But he can't open it yet.
But he can't open it yet.
Gotcha. And now it is Rat Boy.
Roll me a stealth check again, Patrick.
Yeah. Normal?
A stealth check, yeah.
Yeah. And normal?
Normal, yes. 14. Okay, so this rat sees you.
Damn.
Uh-oh.
This rat's gonna go ahead and take a swing at you. What's your armor class?
Is it this one you're saying?
Leather.
Yeah.
It's on your core stats, Patrick, on the right armor class, right next to initiative.
I said leather.
Oh.
No, like the
number. There's a number.
14.
11.
The base.
16.
The base. Yeah. Totals. 16, sorry.
Yeah. 16.
Oh, God!
He's gonna crit the crap out of you.
Oh, my butt.
Get ready, the moisture. You might need to heal him first.
So he's gonna slash. And he's just gonna...
He's gonna kill you. He killed you.
No. He's gonna drop. He's gonna do a full 12 damage to you.
He killed you.
So go ahead and go to your character page, where your character page is.
Yeah.
Just delete it.
From mine up. Right away.
So at the bottom right, you'll see a death saving throw. At the bottom right.
Yeah.
Go ahead and roll me one. A 9. So you're gonna fail on your first one.
So click a failure there.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be the next guy, this lizard guy right here.
Uh-huh.
He kinda sees Patrick on the ground, so he's not gonna attack Patrick anymore. He's gonna run over here
right.
And cut right in front of this rat.
Uh-huh.
He's a fast lizard guy. And swing at Justin.
Okay. 18.
Ow. I'm muted until otherwise.
Get him. Get out of here.
Yeah, he's gonna glance across, kinda miss, hit
Get
the
out
ground.
Of here.
He misses you completely, just hits the ground.
Uh-huh.
Uncle Mike. Kurika.
Just do the drag it.
I can't get past these two.
Drag it here. Like this. There's 40.
That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, if he's gotta run through the hallway, yeah.
You can get above Justin. One above Justin. Right there.
Boom. That's your double though.
Yeah.
Alright. Rat next to Patrick there.
It's the rat in front? No.
It's the rat right here. Oh.
He Boing. Can't really do anything. You guys are too crowding up the area a little
bit.
So he's gonna stand there and wait.
Okay.
Can't do anything right now. He's gonna actually attempt to yell and intimidate.
Do I do a saving throw for that?
Nope. He's gonna roll that. He failed.
Okay.
He didn't intimidate you guys at all.
Okay. Trey's up.
Well, I attempt to make friends with Lizard Man again.
Okay, roll me a d20. 's dice on the map.
Oh yeah, I put it there on accident. I can't get rid of it.
Um There's a button here I need.
I don't see Kalf's picture for me to add. Oh, wait. Found it.
I'm pulling out matches, and I'm saying it's customary where I come from to burn of the fallen. Like Patrick on fire.
Okay, so you fail at that, but it was only a cantrip, so you have another action.
Trick. Healing word.
I don't think I can revive dead people.
Yeah, you can. You can totally do it.
He has it. He is not dead yet.
Yeah, he has to fail three times.
Three times.
Healing word's not touch based. It's got range.
Yeah, 30 feet, I think. Right.
60.
60. Even farther. 8 HP healed.
8 HP.
Whoa! Patrick's back in action.
Patrick's back at max, and he is just up in time for his turn.
Patrick, you're alive.
Yeah, sorry.
Welcome back to the land of the living.
Whew. Oh, I was a little bit pissed there hearing that.
You have 8 health, too, by the way.
I heard that. Yeah. That's all. I'm full heal. Yeah, I did. Alright,
I say, welcome back. Those boxes probably look like good shelter.
So, I'm gonna go with a little bit of stealth action again.
You're gonna throw a smoke bomb?
Diversion! Let's do... Yeah, let's go jump in those boxes. Let's...
Roll me a stealth check. You got it.
Oh man, you're killing it.
Get in there. Alright.
So as you get into the boxes, you realize that they're filled with unique stuff and actual gold also.
Okay.
Sweet.
Oh, hang on. I'll be right back.
Okay. Steven's turn? Or Raul's turn?
Raul's turn.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Can I see the lizard guy?
Yes, you
can. All right, I'm gonna cast Witch Bolt on him.
Okay, give me a Witch Bolt cast.
That's the damage. That's the damage.
There is no when it's a cast spell roll. There is no roll me a d20 for your accuracy though.
I thought does he not do like a saving throw?
Yeah, I mean, the lizard will have a saving throw.
Right. Oh.
So you're gonna hit him spot on though. You're still gonna hit him in the area. Your accuracy is fine. But he's going to have a saving throw.
Oh.
He's going to take a little bit more damage, not quite double for a crit, but he's going to take some.
Nice shot.
Yes.
On the lizard man?
From the boxes you hear. Yeah. Nice shot.
You're going to ruin your stealth.
That's why it was quiet.
My turn?
I didn't hear him. Yep, it's going to be Justice.
After stumbling from the first attempted Brad Pitt maneuver, I'm going to attempt a second one.
roll me an acrobatics check, please.
Oh, acrobatics?
Yeah, I'm going to have you roll an acrobatics one on this.
Nice.
Yep, okay, so you're fine on that. So go ahead and roll me your hit.
Mmm!
You're going to annihilate him with a couple damage. Not quite double because it wasn't crit 20.
Yeah.
But it was... You're going to hit him for a good 10 damage there.
Right to the chest.
Who did you kill?
I didn't kill anybody, I don't think.
Kill anybody yet.
I hit the guy right in front of me, though. This guy.
Gotcha. We're Where'd Patrick go?
He's at right here.
I'm stealthed.
He stealthed into the boxes after he was revived.
This distance thing doesn't make any sense.
It's because it's not...
Look, like a rabbit!
It's not what you think it is. It's like 5 for each square, but then it's like... If you move diagonally, it's like 5, 5, and then a 10 for the every third one.
I should fix that.
Okay, so this rat in front of you is gonna go ahead and swing at you.
Oh, okay.
18.
Yep. Get wrecked.
He's gonna miss there. He's gonna glance on you though. He's gonna glance you.
I am tanking so hard. We're up to Calf.
Oh, oops. He missed again, but it's supposed to be a plus 6, but he still missed.
He still missed. It's fine.
Yeah, we're going to go to Calf.
Get him, boy.
Calf's going to open the door.
Uh-huh.
Calf's going to open the door.
Calf, over here.
Get him! I yell.
Not my turn yet. I have all the initiative.
He rolls. He's in the door. He's going to fire at the rat that you've been attacking.
Right, this guy.
So, for accuracy...
Oh,
he hits him.
Yes.
What are you?
He's my boy.
Good shot, Cal.
He's gonna do 1 damage.
He didn't hit him in the right place, but at least he hit him. We're making progress.
It's all that counts, Cal.
Rat in the back.
Rat
that obliterated Patrick.
So he lost where Patrick was. Uh-huh. So he's gonna stand back again in kind of the area to line up to start attacking you.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Get in line, buddy.
And then the lizard man.
Lizard man. I was told we were fighting a rat problem, not a lizard man problem.
Well, you encountered a lizard man. He's probably leading the rats.
Yeah.
Oh,
he's gonna smack you.
Yeah, he is.
Push him in the tray.
Is he smacking?
Me.
He's gonna hit you for 5.
Okay, boys. Alright, now it's Monk Boy.
Come now on, it's Monk Boy's turn.
I say from the boxes.
You're ruining your stuff. They're gonna notice.
Then it'll give you guys time to attack them.
Once they roll me around. A stealth, Patrick.
Yeah.
Stealth.
God!
You still stealth?
I'm still here!
Patrick is one sneaky son of a bitch.
Yeah.
That is why my name is Spicy Boy.
Spicy Boy.
So, Uncle Mike? Mr.
Kirakai.
I look to him Kirakai. expectantly, waiting for a proverb as he strikes. I hold my shield up and I look at him from behind the shield.
Give him a little wink.
I'm in awe of his wisdom.
Kirakai?
Man kicked in testicles left holding back.
I turn back to the rat. I say, and I say, did you fucking hear that?
Hey, Uncle Mike, roll me an intimidation roll.
I shot from the boxes. I shot from the boxes. What did he say?
Boom!
He's intimidated. You're gonna gain an advantage.
So I'm obviously after that amazing quote aiming for his balls.
Right, with your quarterstaff.
Minus to hit that.
Common theme in this group.
Well, no, it's just a straight on hit, Justin. I'm 3'1".
Right.
That's all he really can aim for.
Rat balls are huge too. Big target. Especially on what looks like a 20-foot rat. 26.
The rats, they're gonna blow up.
Oh god. They're just gonna fall out the bottom. Like somebody popping a water balloon with a pin from underneath.
He's gonna fall and he'll go ahead and fall over and die on that one.
Oh my god. Finally avenged my killer.
I still have an unarmed strike.
Yeah, you can't use that because he's dead. I mean,
you can move though. You can move.
He moved. Yeah, he can.
You have a move.
Yeah, you do. He does have a move.
He still has a movement.
And he can still do unarmed strike also.
Get that unarmed strike, boy.
What the fuck up?
You keep hitting max damage rolls.
Your boy doesn't miss.
Your boy doesn't miss.
Like, I think I'm going to make the all-star team this year.
I heard that one.
From the boxes. I heard it that time.
Okay, so this rat is the one in the back, your Uncle Mike. So he's going to roll over here. And he still can't get to you because his rat's in the way.
So this guy's not dead yet?
No, he's not.
Turn in.
Because you know he took 9, right?
Yeah. No, I have their health. I'll tell you pretty much everything they had if you want to at the end. So. Yeah,
9's a high number is just what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I don't know if anybody saw how high of a number I did.
I did 11.
Yeah.
That was your to hit.
Go ahead.
No, that was damage.
It was just damage.
Trey? Is that Trey?
Trey is.
What's your missiles up?
You got this! I shot from the bottom.
Since no one's hurting, I attempt to make friends with Liz.
Oh my gosh.
Third
so,
time.
So roll me.
I have faith this time!
A d20.
You got this!
They heard, go ahead and roll me a stealth check, Patrick, again.
He's gonna hit another 25.
they still don't know he's there.
It's great, this is great.
Trey hears him, and gets, he gets advantage roll, so he gets to roll another 1d20.
Nice! Get it this time, boy! Have faith! All the faith!
Thank you, Fog.
You have not hit any spells at all.
Stop.
2 days in a row. Stop he didn't
trying.
Even have to. He didn't have to miss. Roll for a heal.
Stop trying. I yell from
the You just fight, man. Set something on fire at this point.
All right, Spice so boy. So whoever's close, I guess.
Just jump out of the boxes onto the back of this rat right here.
Let's see.
Stab him in the jugular.
I'm a little scared, so I feel like I'm gonna get one shot again.
Yeah.
If you would all care to meditate, I'll finish this up.
And not approvingly.
Can I do a little searchy search in the boxes and get an attack, or is that
in the? Go ahead and roll me. Yeah, you can. I'll allow it. Go ahead and roll me a. Yeah, go ahead and roll me a perception check. Yeah, you didn't find anything.
Yeah,
we ain't found shit.
There's gold in front of your face, and you don't even see it there.
And I couldn't find it. All right.
You couldn't find it at all. Nothing.
All right, so we're jumping out. Dual sword swords. On this rat's back, going for the back of his neck.
So you got two short swords, so you're dual wielding here.
Yes.
So you want to go ahead and, of course, sneak attack. You've got advantage.
Yes. So do I need to...
Roll for two short swords. And you're going to get on his back, so yeah. Roll me an acrobatics first.
Wait, hang on. Okay. Get this little action real quick.
You jump straight on his back. Give me a damage from your sword. Yeah, give me a just give me your sword attack, and we're not going to worry about
hitting
advantage. With... advantage hitting. This is going to be you jumping on his back and holding onto his back with your sword in it. So eight. He's going to take an 8. We're disregarding the attack.
Okay.
So you land. Your sword goes into his back with the acrobatics check. So that's how you're holding on. Is you're holding on to.
But I have two of them.
Yeah, you have one, so you're going to have another attack afterwards.
Yeah, put your character on his space, in his back.
Okay, sorry.
Boop. Nice.
Right on his back.
So now you roll your other sword with advantage?
Other sword with advantage.
Okay.
Nice.
Wow!
with a sneak attack, so plus 1d6 damage.
And give me a 1d6.
Drum roll, please. Brrr.
Pass.
Bow. 4.
Suck it, rat.
So he did 8 and then 13. He did 21 damage.
Please tell me he's dead after that. That's gotta be
he's badass not dead.
Fuck off, rat.
But you're on his back.
Yeah, with your knives.
I'm on his hand.
With your knives in him. It looks like you're climbing a mountain with ice picks, but with swords on the back of a rat.
Yeah, there you go.
Nice.
As I yell, I'm on his hand.
On the back of the ogre.
On his hand.
And I'm looking at Kurakai yelling, I'm on his hand.
So Raul the Magnificent.
You better
continue to shoot lightning at this guy.
Witch bolt.
Lightning bolt.
Yeah.
Hit him.
It's concentration.
Alright, 10 damage.
Is there a concentration?
It says concentration underneath it. I don't know.
I just continue to damage him.
Yeah.
There's no concentration roll, so.
Right. Well, it's just interrupted if he takes damage.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So,
This is Witch Bolt, too. So, the Witch Bolt is already affecting him.
Yeah, that's what he's saying. He just keeps taking damage. Yeah.
Yeah. So, he took another 10. Okay.
I am going to jump onto the back of the dead rat that has fallen on the ground in front of me.
Okay, and... roll in acrobatics.
Oh, come on.
You're going to leap off of him.
I'm going to do it.
A little vault action.
He's a big rat. Okay, so you climb on top of him. You don't really jump.
All right, it wasn't graceful, but I'm on top of him, right?
Yes, you're on top of him.
Okay, and I'm going to attack the lizard. But as I climb up onto the back of the rat, I sling my shield over my shoulder, and then I jump off the back of the rat with my trident in both hands over my head, and I'm going to come down into him. Yeah.
Okay.
Two-handed.
First to roll to see if you pull your dick out.
wait, roll. Why haven't you been using the wiener? That's right.
Well, you still have the wiener, Raul.
It's not in my inventory.
Put it in your inventory.
10. It crits. So I jump at him. Is that what my is attack? I just rolled a 10 for the wiener. Or I rolled a 20 for the... Yeah, rolled a 20 for the wiener. So I just roll my attack?
Yeah, roll your attack.
Boom.
You get... There's a bonus for you having two-hander, right?
Yeah, the bonus is it looks badass.
Yeah, it looks sick as fuck.
Super badass.
I don't know. Where I don't know if I see that.
We're just gonna go with he took 7 right now.
Oh.
I can look it up. I can look it up.
Yeah, I'm about to look at the weapons part.
Oh, yeah. Order hall piece number 5.
Oops.
and it's not loading for me anyway.
That's fine. Seven's good. I hit him for seven.
And I Lizard Man for seven?
Jump off of him. Two hands with the trident. Right into his chest.
Lizard Man is on the ground and he died.
He died?
He died.
God, that was so badass. I say to myself.
KS, roll. KS.
He lands in a heap with me in between, like, right on his chest, like, superhero kneeling pose with my trident sticking into his heart. God, I'm glad I picked the trident.
Okay. Kelf,
get him, buddy.
So Kelf is gonna shoot at this right over here in front of Uncle Mike.
Right.
Oh, Uncle Mike. Oh, you're short.
You're in a dangerous position.
That's okay.
Very dangerous position.
He'll probably miss.
He did with fucking three. No
way. Roll me an acrobatic check.
He's not hitting an AC 19.
Roll an acrobatic check.
I already told you he was.
No, you, Uncle Mike. Oh.
He didn't hit you.
He's not hitting an AC 19. That's okay, Calf. You didn't hit anybody.
Okay, so what rat's alive? That rat's alive. So he's going to point towards Uncle Mike and he's going to say, this bitch.
Nice.
So,
and he's going to go ahead and swing at Uncle Mike. He's going to yell, let out a screech.
And then I say, watch out, Uncle Mike. He looks like he's going to attack you.
Plus six.
Plus so six?
For his attack. But he doesn't. That's not damage. That's not damage. That's the AC against your AC. So he rolled a 17 against a 19 AC. You're fine. So you take you. He misses. He hits you, but
no. He swings at you and it just doesn't even go low enough. He's too tall.
He's like Neo Matrix style and just bend at the knees. And
yeah.
You bend at the knees and you lean back and your total height is 1 foot.
I can slide under the door.
Yeah. You limbo under his door. We throw you through the keyhole.
Okay, so this rat has Patrick on his back right here.
Right.
He's going to...
Hold on, I was skipped.
You were not.
He totally was.
Yeah, he was.
He's 20.
Uncle Mike's first.
I don't know why Uncle Mike got deleted, but he did. So Uncle Mike, you go and attack.
So the one that growled at me,
yeah.
Which one is that?
The one in front of you.
So I tell him as I swing my quarterstaff that if one wants to become a master fisherman, one must first become a master baiter.
Nice. and you whack him?
Damn right I do.
Give him a whooping.
Give him the business. We see the business.
I don't want to see the business.
Does that hit?
I don't know. Yeah.
Better hit.
Yeah, and he's dead. he took a crumbles because Uncle Mike hit him twice before?
No, once before with a 9.
Once before, so he's not dead. So yeah, sorry, he's not dead. He's still got
That's a good thing I have an elbow.
Wait. Holy crap! Max damage, unarmed strike again.
You smack him, and now he's gonna die.
So, Uncle Mike, here's what I see happening, right? I see you spin your quarterstaff over your head and hit him once, and then do that thing where you, like, tuck it behind your back and palm him right in the chest.
That's right. Damn right.
And he falls over backwards, dead.
I did exactly that.
Have knives in this guy's neck.
Okay, so this guy's gonna.
How is he not paralyzed?
He's gonna run. He's gonna actually run, and you're on his back still.
Yeah.
And so do me an athletics check.
Athletics, save me.
Okay, so you stayed on his back. But he's running around the room, swinging his arms, trying to get you off.
I laugh.
Wait, Trey, can we do a combo attack?
Moisture missile.
Huh? Set him on fire.
A combo.
Are you getting him or something?
What, Huckle Mike?
So this one's the only one alive?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
I stick my finger on his nose. And I decide to produce a little bit of flame.
You're touching him, so he's going. He's going to have a saving throw right here. You hit him.
Uh-huh.
And he's going to take 5 damage. Uh-huh.
That's it.
He's still alive.
You killed the order.
You killed the box.
Oh, oops. Spicy boy.
I yell to Raul. I say, throw me that penis you still have.
I say, what? I didn't hear you.
Great.
Never mind, I say.
I said, this is going to be fun.
Guys, I drew up a little diagram in Discord about what my last attack looked like.
Did you hold that pose?
Yeah, dude. Except that was his balls in my clenched fist.
Nice. I give you an approving nod.
What you doing, Patrick?
All right, doing,
spicy boy.
Let's just finish him off. I'm gonna wait.
You're gonna give him a happy ending.
Hang on. I'm gonna pull a Black Widow. I'm gonna wrap my legs around his neck, and I'm gonna flip myself around to his front and knife stab him in the neck, both sides in the neck.
So acrobatics check, please.
Nail it. Nail it.
Oh. So you get,
do I fall
you
off?
Get one. Or do I no, get... you don't fall off. You get 1 foot around his neck, and you kind of like you're dangling.
Catch,
your one
do I catch on? Do I catch on with a sword?
you don't, but you haven't attacked yet. But you're holding on with 1 foot. You're kind of like falling off. Okay. So if he shakes you around again, he's definitely gonna make you fall.
I will fly off. I will fly. Well, I'll go with one sword attack here and a little hijaw into his throat.
Into his throat.
As I'm falling, I drop my other one and I slide down his chest.
You like stab it in him and then like slide down.
Yeah. And then nice. I use my weight to pull down the sword to open up his rib cage.
Nice. He did 19 with 9 piercing.
Yeah, no, he hit. He definitely killed him. He cut.
Oh, yes. Open. Are we out of combat now, too?
His guts on his floor. You're out of combat.
Woohoo!
And then I roll around in his guts.
I say, that's gross.
Like a pig in a mud puddle.
Cool, goodness. I'm going to check this door right here.
All
right,
well,
and I say, first off, I say, good job, team. I kind of want to meditate when we're done with this. After seeing that display.
I sit right here in the middle and meditate.
Patrick.
Sit on the dead rat.
Patrick, roll me a
D10. That's the middle.
Yeah.
How do I move the rat to the background so I'm on top?
Do we get experience?
So. A weird magic aura comes from the cellar, and you guys are all sitting there.
It's as big as a fucking football field.
And you kind of sense that you're like kind of almost in a trap, like kind of thing. You're like locked down in the cellar now,
And this magical surge comes across, and Spicy Boy can't speak. He figures out he's unable to speak.
Thank God.
when he tries to speak, he can only bark like a dog. for a minute. He can only do it for a minute. It's only going to last a minute.
So. I say, well, that's fucking weird. And then I check this door. Shut up! Heal! Oh, it's a money door.
I'm going to inspect these boxes.
Roll me a d20.
Do I have to pay a blood price?
Points at boxes. I like that. Raul, you find a couple gold. You get a good stack of gold. You get 20 gold.
Yes.
Okay, Calf, check the boxes.
Calf, check the boxes.
Yeah. Roll it, Calf. He finds nothing.
Ralph finds a couple spare gold. He's got 4 gold on him.
Nice.
Calf.
And he's feeling a little generous right now. He's actually gonna give the 5 extra pieces of gold he got to Raul there.
I throw him on the ground.
Patrick's still barking. I say, what a nice gesture, Calf. And then to myself, I say, what fucking stupid rolls. Learn to roll.
Yeah. So, Patrick, you're done. Thank God. You don't have to bark anymore.
Ooh, that one was just for fun.
So you guys can all check the boxes if you want to roll.
I want to open this money door.
You want to open this money door? Roll me.
Can I tell if it's trapped?
Perception.
Wait, hang on. Let me do that.
Let me look if it's trapped here.
I have expertise in perception.
Well, then you come roll after if I don't find anything.
Well, I rolled first.
Just shush. Do I see anything?
What?
You do not. You don't see that it is if it's trapped or anything.
I back up a little bit and I say, hey, I don't know if this door is trapped or not, but I went in. And I went in
I
now.
Say, hang on. And I turn to Patrick and go, woof, 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 woof.
I understood that.
I get that reference.
I understand that.
Does anybody want to check this door for me?
Yeah. Can I get a little? I rolled 14 for the box.
Go ahead and 14 for the box.
Yeah.
You find a handful of gold and you actually found a potion. In the box, actually.
What kind of potion?
All you know is it's a potion. It's kind of in a vial. It's
a vial.
It's a vial.
How many golds did I find?
You found a good stack of 40 gold.
Dang. You should throw it on the ground.
I will not.
I pick up the gold rattle too on the ground.
good idea. I would like to check if
door's trapped.
Door's trapped.
Accept right. It.
Perception roll, please.
Oh shoot, no, I'm not. Oh well, that's not a good idea. I forgot it's not perception. No, I'm persuasion.
It's inception.
Anyone else have wisdom?
Roll it anyway. Just roll it anyway.
Alright, let's see what we got here, boys.
You're right.
Oof, even less.
Bush did it.
Anybody?
You have no idea.
I am going to determine the perception of this.
Okay. You do not You do not know if you still don't know if it's trapped or not.
Oh god.
Guys, this is not trapped.
All right.
I'm sure of it.
Okay. I have no reason to not trust you so far.
So let's send Calf first.
Yes.
So all in favor, say aye.
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 So I'm gonna try and open this door.
No, send Raul first.
Nice.
Aye.
I'm gonna. Do you want to check before I try?
No, go ahead.
Okay. I mean, you were gonna say something.
And I'm pretty far back here. Like, I'm sure my voice echoes at this distance. I'm gonna say, no, really.
It's okay. I said this is gonna be fun.
Wait, hang on. Can we use the rat as a shield just in case?
Oh, can I use body parts?
The body parts?
Hold on. I hold my shield up in front of me, and yeah.
Use Cap's arm to.
No, I try and open the door.
And I will follow boldly behind you.
I have my shield up at the ready.
So the trap goes off.
So it goes off. Yeah, right.
So it goes off, and it hits everybody within 20 feet.
Uh-huh.
Can you throw me some AC saving rolls? Whatever your saving rolls are.
Me?
I have wisdom or charisma.
You in 20 feet.
So I have a charisma saving roll. Is that what you're talking about? What are you talking about? Where's my AC?
Yes.
Charisma?
Yes. Charisma saving roll.
It's an ugly bomb?
Boom.
What's the AC? Okay.
It's 13 for me, I think.
It's a 14 save on the trap. So.
Okay. So I got 16.
And Patrick, you also get hit, so I need a charisma saving throw. Or, I mean, I whatever need a saving throw, whatever your saving throw is.
I have two. Can I just roll the higher one?
You pick the higher one, yeah.
Oh, fuck you, trap.
Oh, God.
Oh!
He deflects the trap back on itself.
Yeah. Yeah, I counter-trap the trap.
So the trap goes around, and you don't take any damage at all, but Patrick's not affected. I mean, Spicy Boy's not affected by this trap.
Clearly.
At all. Like, he completely misses it. Completely.
There was a trap?
But... But Justin doesn't take any damage, but he gets deafened by it. It was a loud, like, thunder sound. And he gets deafened, so all he can hear is like, whoa, 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 whoa.
Mop. I go, mop, mop, mop.
Now that's how you get tonight.
And I turn around, and I look at, I make eye contact with the Kirikai. And then I motion to my crotch. I do like the hand chop motion right there. And then I turn back around and I open the door. Couldn't possibly be worse than that.
Trey, go ahead and roll me a...
Okay, what? I opened the door.
A D10. A D10.
Trey, please roll something above a 2.
God dang it!
Please get I offer to end Trey's life.
Another magical surge goes through the dungeon or the cellar of it, and all of a sudden Trey forgets everybody's name.
Well,
it wouldn't surprise me if you didn't know our names in the first place.
I am going to open the door.
The door is open.
Thank God, I'm in.
Oh, thank God.
Monkeys with swords. I turn around and yell.
Monkeys with swords. I can go stealth boy.
You want to... Hold on. I have 9 hit points. I'm gonna heal myself with my lay on hands to 14.
Okay.
So I have no more heal until I rest.
So let me get this straight. You just went into a room and touched yourself?
Yes.
What's your problem?
My hands began to glow, and then I did another crotch chop and healed myself.
As you thrust your hips.
Yeah. And then I begin to glow. And I'm going, mop. Mop.
Okay, so you come into this room and there's
are we gonna roll initiative?
I peek around the corner and then I turn around and I tell the rest of the people, I think I'm talking at a normal level, but I'm really shouting. And I go, there's definitely enemies back here.
And Justin ruins the element of surprise. And we're at a disadvantage. Way to go.
I say, can you shut that cat up?
Go!
So he started making cat noises now?
He was a dog noises. He was a dog, now he's a cat. Alright, I step back.
Oh, what's going on?
So Patrick, you move to the left a little bit. Move up a little bit. I'm backing up.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Here. I'm full on going in.
Oh. Leroy!
Leroy, no!
What's that, man?
The bloodlust has gone to his head. He hasn't failed yet. He doesn't know what failure's like.
That's right.
He hasn't tasted failure.
All he tastes is blood.
At this point, I'm convinced that Buddha has blessed me and that I can't miss.
Okay, so hold on. Stop moving real quick.
Yeah.
I can't.
Trey, there's a special interaction right now.
Yeah, it's my foot in these guys' asses.
Raul, roll me a perception. I mean, not a perception check, a persuasion check.
Okay.
He's gonna persuade a walnut.
Normal.
Yeah. So.
Like I said.
So you. You tell him, I'm gonna have to do that in secret to Trey. Okay.
Man, you guys are the backbone of the team here.
They're passing notes to each other.
Well, Trey doesn't even know his name.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's right.
Trey doesn't
know anybody's names. As we're about to fight, I turn around and say, guys, this is a chance for us to start a new life. To really form our identity how we want it to be.
I take Calf, first initiative.
Calf, you can have not a stupid name.
he changes. He takes that off on himself, and I'm going to hold
him. He's going to roll another name? Excellent.
Oh, no, he sticks with Calf. He's like, I like Calf.
Oh, okay. And I say, I didn't mean that, what I said before. It's really a great name.
Go ahead and roll me a persuasion check. Persuasion, Justin. Just for fun.
Okay.
Maybe you have enough persuasion to persuade
so,
him. To
so he
name.
Changes his name. He changes his name.
Nice!
He likes you so much, Kurt. He changes his name to
Kurt. All in favor of Kurt.
He changes his name to Calvin.
Calvin! Nice. I go, ooh, okay.
He tells you that the only reason he switched to Calvin is because it's a whole lot easier to pronounce for everybody else.
Oh. I turn back to him and I say, Calvin, really? I say, how about you take on your dad's name, a family name that was your dad who was killed by pirates.
You mean Calf?
And he probably changes his name back to Calf.
You know what? Calvin's okay. And I, so let's just drop it. You mean
I thought Calf. That was great.
You Calf. Mean Calf?
Calf, the original troll.
He's my favorite so far. How about you do your father's name? Oh, you mean Cal. You know what? Never mind. Oh, I'm so glad Calvin's with us.
So everybody floods into the room.
Right.
So Raul and Trey can also move. Okay. Everybody roll for initiative.
Did you crit on a 6? Why is it red?
What?
I don't know why his shirt's of a different color. Oh, because that's the one that's at the top currently. Can you change Calf's name to Calvin?
Oh, yeah. Hold on.
How come I'm the only one with a name here?
Yeah, mine's the only name that shows up.
Oh, nobody else's? Okay, cool.
No, yeah.
I see everybody's name, so right. I don't know.
That doesn't. Yeah, I guess you're the only one. That...
Oops. I need to switch his name to Kel. Oh, I can't edit him for some reason.
I can edit, probably.
I should be able to name
it. Oh, it's changed. It's probably not because it doesn't matter. It's fine. I have it right.
Calvin.
All right, who's up? Moisture.
Okay.
Why are you? How many Calvins are there? There's.
What?
He was right here.
I there's proceed there to say to.
No, you can't. You don't know their names, so you have to.
To this person standing in front of me,
yell at the
he looks like a faggot wizard.
Oh God!
So you yell, faggot wizard.
Uh-huh.
And I say, I don't know who. That person is. I don't know who you are, and I. So I proceed to set him on fire.
You set the monk on fire.
No.
The person in front of me.
The dick wizard.
That nice. You set him on fire. Okay. What did he try to convince you? I'm a little concerned.
Do I have to do a saving roll or something?
Yeah, roll me a intellect saving roll.
Click on that. Boom.
So you don't ignite on fire.
Deflected.
But Raul, it's your turn.
But did they switch places?
No.
Raul, it's your turn.
There we go.
I'm gonna cast Magic Missile.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead.
Are you gonna do
shoot all of them?
All three? Okay.
Wait, I have to actually do a...
Yeah, you have to do one for each.
Roll me a d20 against their armor class.
You have all three? He doesn't have to roll one for each. I feel.
No, it's one spell. It's still one spell.
I know, but they're three different ones. He's got to aim all three.
Because a magic missile has one to hit.
One to hit.
Oh, okay.
And it'll hit all the target. Yeah.
All right. Well, so 19.
It's a 19.
Yeah.
So what's the damage? Cast four. It three times.
Four. Three.
You kill the first guy. Which one were you aiming at?
Yeah, he had all three. No, he was doing one of each.
One of each?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to do one of each.
Okay.
But I guess I kill the first one, the closest one.
If you kill the closest anybody. One? Yeah, he's going to die.
Monk time.
Monk time.
Double so kill.
How tall is Justin?
6'7".
Dude, okay, launch him off your shield. Okay. Launch him off
your shield. Before this happens, I look down at him and I like raise my hands up to my face like I'm ready to see what's about to happen. Like I have like my hands balled up and they're like right by my cheeks and I'm like dancing back excited. And forth, ready to go.
Like excited. Yeah. Like Stan.
Yeah.
Stan from American Dad.
Yeah, I'm like bouncing up and down.
Like I'm running towards the monkey as I go past Justin, I want to like jump and rebound off like his hip.
Could I Spartacus
that first
you?
First monkey's dead.
Yeah.
Can I Spartacus throw you off my shield into the second monkey over here?
Yeah, we call that cannonballing.
Oh, nice. I'm going to cannonball you.
So, acrobatic cannonball. Check and strength check for Justin.
But
I'm obviously going to make this because I have a 21 dex.
Just so roll.
It will be impossible for me to miss.
Wait, Uncle Mike, so I just want you to kill the next
one. Oh,
roll strength. Roll just strength saving throw.
Okay.
No. You have a.
Roll a 20 plus my strength, yeah?
You have a. Hold on. There's something for this.
Hey, Uncle Mike, don't kill that next guy. I'm going to do a cool thing as
well. Well,
you just do athletics because athletics is also strength.
Okay.
Athletics. That's yeah. That's
okay. And
so
I'm
you
proficient.
Want me to kill this?
Yeah. And I'm proficient in it.
Don't kill the next guy.
18.
Yep.
No, the guy in the back.
Yeah,
don't kill the other one though.
Which one? Which one are you killing?
The brown one.
The brown one.
Okay, this one in the back.
That one.
Yeah. Okay, so you jump onto my shield and I throw you across the room.
And I'm going to unarmed strike with my foot first.
Okay.
You're just going to overkill this monkey?
Yeah, because you're about to roll
would you
max
say,
damage.
Would you say that in a cannonball maneuver, that is clearly an advantage?
Yes. Yes. It is an advantage. Yes. Yes.
Yep. 24 of it.
Pow!
Pow!
Are you saying?
So he stumbles back.
And then I quarterstaff his.
Yep.
This bitch ass.
Bam!
Holy crap! Can you be stopped?
So this monkey was already dead from the cannonball kick.
You're right. I was already mid swing.
So, that's what I was saying.
Like, there's no stopping it.
Yeah,
it was
so
all one motion.
And when you make contact,
you hit front, just a limp body.
No, because he's falling back and like in mid.
It's like I kicked his chin up and teed it up like a T-ball and cracked.
And he hit him with the quarterstaff and his head just explodes and just cakes the wall on the left side. Just like pah, under the wall.
I developed PTSD.
Roll for flashbacks.
Please roll.
I after that happens, I go, holy shit!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ! No, please roll for flashback.
Right, you should
look at the destroyed corpse, and I say, lay down or be cut down. It's your.
Not a choice anymore.
So... You gave him the choice after his head exploded.
Justin, your go.
I just sit down. I just sit down. I sit down on the ground.
Okay, Justin sits.
Oh my god.
Spicy boy.
Spicy boy.
No, my headset down.
Oh, so. Sorry. You ready, Uncle Mike?
Hell yeah.
I'm about to give you a double kill here. Serve you up hot. You ready?
I can't miss.
I know. It's great.
Unkillable.
So I'm going to sneak attack.
If well, you're right, no can defense.
I'm going to stealth over to Monkey real quick. Stealth roll. Pacha.
Yep.
And as I do this, I say, Kurikai, batter up. And I sweep his legs out from underneath him, and Kurikai swings for the fence.
Kurikai can't swing.
Sweep the leg.
But you're going to sweep him?
Yeah.
Okay, so give me a athletics check.
Advantage or no?
Yes. Advantage because you're stealth, yes. Yeah, 20, you crit, so you completely kick out his foot. So
crippled him.
So again, because it's the turn order, you have to wait all the way until Uncle Mike, but this guy's gonna be in that motion the entire time.
It's like 6 seconds, right? It's 6 seconds per round, is that what it is?
Yes. Almost. Per round, yes, mm-hmm. Per round. You're right.
Okay, Calf.
That's or what Calvin. I'm doing.
Or Calvin. Calvin can shoot
him. He launches him, so the monkey's still falling over, and Calvin launches his arrow and hits the monkey.
Nice. Way to go, Calves.
And smacks the monkey there.
Nice wording.
Snipes the shit out of
nice
him.
Nice wording there.
Smacks the monkey. Spank the monkey.
Yeah.
In the chest. So the monkey is at disadvantage. So, I mean, he's not at disadvantage, but he's falling over. You tripped him up. He can't attack. So it's going to go straight to Trey. Watch your missile.
Not really much I can do, because I can't hit anybody for shit.
Better light it on fire.
Heal yourself. You can't screw that up.
I can't heal anything. I have nothing to heal.
Exactly.
Heal the rat.
Try to light the monkey on fire.
Heal the rat.
Please, God, no. Heal the monkey.
I thought we were fighting rats.
Wait, can you res the lizard?
There are rats and monkey costumes.
res the lizard in the other room.
I want to fight him again. Keep resing him.
I need more experience.
I try to revive the lizard.
It's too far. You can't run that far.
You can't run that far.
Come back behind Raul.
Yeah, he was over here.
I try to make friends with said monkey in front of me.
Nice. Do you not have weapons?
Yeah, I hope you.
He's got something.
I have my staff, but I need to get better at using my finger.
Roll that two.
Oh my god.
Oh, I thought you tried to make friends with them. Not
oh, that's damage. That's damage. Roll a d20.
Oh, oops. Wrong one. I meant to click my.
He rolled a one anyway, though. What is happening?
Meant to roll his animal friendship.
Animal friendship. Okay. So roll a d20.
What is this? There's no way Uncle this
Mike,
is right. This is no
Uncle
way.
Mike can't miss. Yeah. And Trey always misses.
Except for when it doesn't count, like when you set the boat on fire.
You're right. He rolled a 20 on the boat fire one.
Yeah.
Is that monkey still alive? How?
Monkey is still alive.
I crit him. He has one health. And then Cal sniped him.
Sniped him, but he still got. He has one health left.
Yeah.
He literally has one health left.
Roll. You're up.
Roll. You're up.
Wait, how did I kill that one with 4 damage?
You did then, 4 damage with your missile.
Yeah, and then you decided to kill all the other ones.
You decided to kill one.
You decided to kill one, so all of them hit him. That's what we decided. You could either hit them all.
No,
or kill
I said
one.
I hit all of them.
You did one each.
Yeah.
I'm confused.
I thought you meant that one of them died because I did 4 damage.
No.
Yeah, he said you could kill one of them, and so. When you said I thought the same thing he did. Like I knew you wanted to hit all 3, but when you say I hit all of them, I thought you meant you hit all of them on one.
No.
To kill the guy, because he said you can kill.
Well, we already cannonballed one of them.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's fine.
Dead. Yeah. Like murder.
Yeah.
So it's your choice, Roland.
So.
It's too late now because.
Yeah.
That one would have gone anyways.
Justin, throw you.
I can't really reach him, so
you're gonna wait for the grand finale.
Yeah.
Nice. I'm ready to see this one play out.
There you go, Uncle Mike.
Away.
It's my turn.
Yep.
Swing away, old friend.
Okay, here's what's gonna happen.
On ball two.
Here's what's gonna happen. What's
gonna happen. That monkey didn't hurt. I'm gonna lay my quarterstaff over it, teeter totter style, and I'm gonna be on one end, and Patrick's gonna jump on it and launch me into the air.
You're on the dead one right here.
Yeah. I'm using it, the dead one, as a fulcrum.
Nice.
So I want an acrobatics check from Uncle Mike as well as from Patrick.
I feel like we should make an engineering check of some sort as well.
Look at that 24.
I'll do that.
I'll do that.
Yeah, it's good.
It checks out.
Checks out.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, so it's complete.
It works.
Easy.
Easy.
All right, so I'm assuming I only get my unarmed strike since
your quarter staff.
Yes.
But he's got one health.
You better swan dive fist first into his skull.
Can I go balls first? Can I do that? My balls.
Sure.
I'll allow it.
Hey, remember, I have a 9 intelligence.
Same. You crit him.
You crit him with your balls.
With your balls.
This is where you retire from Ultimate Teabag.
This is where we end. This is it. We can never play D&D again.
Uncle Mike just crit with his balls.
He crit with his balls and the monkey explodes just completely.
Well, he can't
from the
talk
most awesome
because his mouth is full.
No, he definitely takes a dent. He's dead.
I faint.
Actually, Justin, you're gonna roll a d10. Magical surge time.
I do not like this place.
For some reason, eggs blast out of you.
From
eggs.
What?
I have
it's
no
vagina.
Idea.
China.
and hit everybody within 10 feet. So.
So Raul and Patrick.
Raul and Patrick get hit.
With eggs.
Oh, and Uncle Mike.
No, Uncle Mike's 15.
Yeah.
Uncle Mike's 10. He's 10.
Yeah, look.
Uncle Mike's 10. Yep.
And Cal.
Busy nursing my own eggs.
Hey, maybe Justin could lay his hands on your eggs.
I have no more hand laying available.
Well, maybe you could just help him anyway.
I wake back up after being blinded from all the brilliance. And I say kind of under my breath, but kind of at everybody else, is like, man, I need to meditate. And then I open this door.
I attempt to open this door.
There's eggs on me?
How much did we get damaged?
Yeah, was there any damage? So there's just eggs on me.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just the inconvenience.
I'm just going to wipe off the eggs.
Nice. How much? What? You're going to roll? You're going to roll for egg wiping?
No, on the door.
Oh, me on the door?
For the egg wiping.
Hey, have we gotten any experience yet? Because I'm ready to experience it.
You get experience.
You just experience me ball dropping.
Experience is done at the end. Whenever we're done.
Boom.
So you rolled 2d20. Why?
I rolled the 10 for the magic surge, and then you asked me to roll a 20 for the door, 20. And I crit the door.
Crit the door. So there was a trap on the door, but
I finessed it.
And the trap didn't go off
right
at all.
And I
disabled.
And then I heel kicked the door in.
And then so it opens.
I heel kicked the door. Nice. What is that?
Those are stairs. The stairs.
Up or down?
The fuck?
Down.
What stairs are these?
Downstairs.
Are we going into freaking hell?
Do we pause?
What?
It looks like we got a lot more dungeon to cover here.
What is this? Is this a door?
Wait, I wanted to kick that down.
Oh, that doesn't look good.
You rolled to kick it. You missed. You failed to kick it down. You hit it, and
fell backwards.
Stumbled back.
Yeah.
Cool.
You didn't even try to jiggle it.
All right.
Just a little bit. Are we going to abandon that door? I kind of want to know what's in that door.
Well, we can go this way.
Well, I don't want to go downstairs yet.
No, there's a bunch of
doors. Go downstairs. We can go through this door. This hallway.
That's another money door.
It connects. Oh, I don't know those things. How do you?
Because it looks like an S. I can see a little bit.
Those are the stuff the map randomly places. I will determine whether it has stuff or not.
Is this another money door?
It shows money door. Yeah.
Wait, can I check this door, David?
Yeah, let roll check.
Standing the door. Here. What's forever.
That? Roll 20. Roll d20.
I don't know what's going on.
Roll 7. But that door's open. It opens. It's just a little dinky door.
Go in there. Oh God, it's a hallway.
It connects to the door that you guys couldn't get into.
Oh, it's the arrow door that you got shot with.
Ooh. What's this E?
You find a random E on
You find an E on the ground.
Building codes require the labels to be proper, the exits to be proper.
Alright, I'm gonna... I know this money door is trapped, right? Can I tell that it's like a similar door from the last one?
Roll me a perception check.
Perception. Despair.
Nice.
What could go wrong? While trying to examine the door,
it goes off.
You fall forward into the door, and it opens.
Oh, just falls open?
Yeah, it didn't have a trap or anything.
Oh. Way to go, klutz.
Let's go into that room.
Calf, come on.
Calvin.
Come on, Calvin!
I'm liking this.
I think Trey's jerking off to the dead monkeys in the corner.
No, my guy's about to take a nap because I have to go to bed.
Alright.
I have to be
out. Yeah, that's what I was saying. I think should we pause? Can I see what's in this room
first?
Can
you see what's in here first?
Oh, God.
So yeah, y'all can fight him while I go to bed.
We're gonna pause.
Menopause.
I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Alright,
yeah.
See ya.
Yeah,
I gotta go. Hey, Uncle Mike, I gotta say, that was one of the sweetest things I've ever seen. in my entire life.
Well, that I visualized, at least.
Like, the fact that I just witnessed a 3-foot-1 monk obliterate a bunch of rats and monkeys.
And then promptly kill
so,
one with his
so gracefully and with so much tact and... And
it's
just
clear I got training from the finest masters.
I mean, it's incredible. I don't know what we would have done if we didn't walk past your bush.
It's like the gods strike through you.
If we had not stumbled upon your bush, I don't know what we would have done. Incredible.
Incredible. Incredible thought.
All right, ready? 3, 2, 1, ending.